the agenda, we're going to talk about updates on what see me in slides. This is why I don't do them. on what the National Advisory Council has been up to since summit, and then our the priorities that we've come up with, the Brigade Rally Cry, and Brigade Action Teams, and talk about is getting louder. And then I'll give you the link to the Brigade survey if you didn't already pick that up in the blog post. And then we'll talk Q&A. So getting right into it, since we last spoke, behind the scenes we've been doing a lot of stuff, even though it seems like we've been kind of quiet. CFA hired Sarah Henry as facilitator to hash out some of the common goals for the Brigade. We met twice for the facilitated workshops, and then two times after that to kind of synthesize the information that we got. We came up with, the goal was to establish responsibilities of the NAC, code from America staff and brigade leaders, and set up priorities for new initiatives for 2017. Pretty much our main objective is to grow up and not grow out. In the past, CFA's focus has been on network expansion, but specifically with NAC and CFA's refocus, the intent is to grow the network maturity and not necessarily focus on expansion. In order to do that, we need infrastructure. There isn't very much infrastructure now, and it certainly isn't built with the intent for a mature network, so that's the plan. The way we do that is we improve communication between brigades, share resources across the network, and establish a sustainable financial model. So the goals for the network, like I said, it's the main thing is how maturity translates, right? Transitioning to a community-led governance, how us actually meeting on our own without CFA, things like that show our maturity. And how we, part of the intent is to tell a new story, right? To recognize brigades for their milestones, which we expect to inspire and the network and re-engage them, and also attract funding. And all of these things are, the intent of them is to show our maturity as a network. Okay. We all good so far? Christopher? Silence. So what we're trying to get done in 2017. It can kind of be summed up in the infrastructure plan is reconnection, recognition, collaboration, sustainability, and sharing. All good things, all things that we've said and we've heard a few times before. So we're going to go over kind of the plan and what we think, how it's going to shake out. For reconnecting with the brigades, we've gotten a list of all of the active brigades, and each of the 9 NAC members are going to go through and select a brigade. It'll probably be about 9 brigades per member, and we're going to reach out and have a conversation with our 9 and then get together and discuss of some way, shape, or form. And the intent is to learn about individual brigade structures and needs, so that we give the brigade members a personal contact within NAC. Part of that connection is if we don't know what other brigades are working on. Austin has some really great stuff on body cam data, and Charlotte is just starting to start a project on that. So it's good for us to connect and have that to learn from their, you know, from what they've already done. So that's part of what we're hoping to do with these conversations, and to establish ongoing mentorships and connecting brigades with similar needs and projects. So on the recognition of milestones, currently there's no badge or award system at all. And if you were able to come to Summit, you know that Noel has been spearheading that effort to create badges and award systems for us. And we got up on stage and gave out a few of them. But one of the things we need to do is expand that. So it's not just the brigades that were in attendance at Summit, it's everybody. And then really develop out how we do those badging systems. What that does is help us tell a better story, uplifting the work of the brigades so that we can not only just inspire each other and share, but also fundraising, recruiting, partnerships, all require that storytelling. When we're better at that, we're better at attracting any of those. And also that also comes along with developing the call to action to re-engage the network. I feel like I skipped one. Nope, I didn't. Ha! Didn't. So cross-brigade collaboration. How that looks is how we all appreciate open data standards. There needs to be network-wide standards on redeployable apps, code of conduct enforcement, including tips and best practices for diversity and inclusion by design, not just by accident. So there's lots of ways that we can do that and make it an easier cross-brigade collaboration. For sustainability, obviously money is important. So developing a sustainable financial model, this will be in partnership with CFA, which will include fundraising toolkits for brigades, as well as partnership strategies on engaging and supporting brigade network. And CFA is working on a new donation platform for the brigades. And also to streamline the in-kind donations that we already receive and figure out what's out there and how we can solicit better ones. By finding out during our conversations with brigade members, what kind of in-kind donations would be of value, we can come back and be better equipped to say, hey, let's go after this one. Ooh. So sharing our knowledge, not reinventing the wheel every time is good. We've been talking, I personally have been in conversations about a shared knowledge base for a couple of years now. What we're gonna do is create one. And it'll kind of act as a wiki, a blog, a best practices, training tools, anything where you can go if you're trying to figure out how to do something and learn from where others have been before you, or tips and tricks that we've already done, or absolute fails so that we don't repeat them. It'll also establish mentorship channels for brigades. CFA will still do any onboarding for new brigades, but then each brigade will match up with not only a NAC member, but other brigades that can help mentor and each other. And we'd like to see more of the trainings come not just from CFA, but also from brigade members training each other. We all have a different skill set, so we might as well start using that to train each other. And the ultimate part of growing up is being able to host our own brigade run events, whether that's a brigade camp, a conference, an event, something, where we all get together independently and just focus on brigade things. And just like a network has to mature with infrastructure, so does NAC. So we've been working on trying to determine the cadence of the NAC and committee meetings, develop election cycles and a process for national council and local brigade leadership, as well as how we determine decision-making between both NAC and how we interact with Code for America staff. And yes, we're still working on all of that. And then there's not all this work can be handled by the brigade and NAC. It's important to recognize that CFA is still very important partnership in this whole process. Some of the shared work we're going to be doing is the sustainable financial model, and make sure that it's not just equal division of resources, but an equitable division of resources. And a content marketing strategy. We'll be working with CFA closely to develop a new website, some branding that differentiates the brigades from CFA so that we can tell our story better. And also develop more training, help develop the onboarding and continuing leadership process. And so CFA support of the brigades. How they're going to do this, develop a centralized Slack. So our Slack will be open to the rest of your leadership team. And then Christopher's been working on cleaning up the CFA Salesforce so they can keep better track of who's part of the network, how they're contributing, what is going on. And all of this will help amplify our stories. CFA has more power to solicit national press to highlight the impact that we're doing. So we're going to leverage that a little bit much better, hopefully. And of course, it takes everybody's, so many hands lighten the load, right? So just give you a quick summary of responsibilities. CFA is still going to handle the day-to-day stewardship of the brigade network, including management, infrastructure, communication channels, website, things like that. Onboarding the brigade leaders and new network partners, promoting brigade stories and helping build a national coalition, maintain database of volunteers and use it to assist with mentorship and opportunities, aid in managing annual CFA brigade conference. NAC's responsibilities is representing you guys, the needs of the brigades, the brigade leaders as elected officials. We advise CFA on brigades' needs and strategies, as also connecting brigades with one another to share resources, creating and leading brigade action teams, which we'll talk about next, and determine setup for future NAC and hold elections, as well as develop a communication strategy. And part that we need you guys for, besides all of the above, to build local coalitions, aid the network in documenting wins and best practices, participate and recruit local members for action teams. So our brigade rally cry. Part of the problem is that it's been difficult in the past to differentiate brigade story versus CFA story. So what the rally cry is intended to do is clarify our message. Here's what we've come up with at this point, which is absolutely open for discussion and debate. We're a national network of community organizers and technologists that are putting technology to work for the benefit of our local communities. It is a little bit broad in general because its intent is to encompass all brigades and we all have very different focuses. But one thing that we definitely all focus on is the benefit of our local communities and how we use technology to do so. So with that, the brigade network principles are pretty clear cut. Change starts locally, and change starts in our neighborhoods, our city halls, our community centers is the local level that we can most directly impact people's lives. And that the people equal all people. So creating inclusive communities is important, and each and every person can participate, not just those with access to power, resources, or technology. And we believe from one another. We learn from one another. We work in the open. We invite participation, transparency, feedback. We share what we are learning with the rest of the network along the way. So now for the Brigade Action Teams, otherwise known as BATs, which, yes, requires a lot of bat kiffies. What are Brigade Action Teams? So our idea is they're a network-wide project team working towards a specific goal. They consist of individual brigade members, not just leaderships. They are open for every brigade member. And we would encourage you to share them with your brigade to have them sign in and get a sense of really like joining the national community. It is led by one NAC member. Usually our intent is to have 2 to 3 in support roles and at least one CFA staff member to support the efforts. So the concept's in beta, which means we're piloting about 4 of them and releasing the others as the NAC leads get them ready. They could come on really quick, like just after the pilots. It just kind of depends on as we get stuff ready. Eventually, the brigade action teams will be self-governing. So one of the first ones that's, I think, ready to be piloted, Vicky will correct me when in a minute, I guess, is the trust and inclusivity. What that is, it's designed to help promote diversity and inclusivity. It'll take the lead on all code of conduct issues, including creating a toolkit to avoid code of conduct issues. And what are your next steps in case something happens? It's led by Vicky, who's on the call. So if you have questions about it, Vicky will be a great one to ask. And it'll be supported by CFA's HR director, Brenda Stone. Another one is the Days of Actions and Events. They'll help take charge of the National Days of Action, i.e. International Open Data Day, which coincides with Code Across, which I believe we're trying to rebrand into Open Data Day. There is National Day of Civic Hacking, normally in June, and then the possibility of a brigade camp event, summit, whatever we're going to call it. And Open Data Day is on March 4th, so that one's coming up really quickly. So that this Brigade Action Team needs to start pretty much now. The National Day of Civic Hacking will be focused on local events this year, without any federal challenges involved. This one does not have a lead just yet, so that one's to be determined, but it is supported by Christopher and is it Constancia? I think so. So that'll be fun. And then there is the knowledge sharing base, which is basically just going to be a centralized place where we can share and learn from each other. A wiki, blog, best practices, idea sharing, how-to guides. It's, as far as the content, it's fairly fluid. The team will be curating the content and developing an architectural structure for it. But all brigade members are encouraged to add content. This is a large project and will be ongoing, so the more help, the better. This one is, I'm leading this one with the support of Nicole. And last but not least is the Brigade Badges and Recognition Team. So we created some badges at Summit, but we forgot to tell anybody about it. So we need to publish the ones that we gave out and make it available for others to sign up for that. Establish a process for awarding the badges, recognition when brigades make an impact in their community, as well as a digital something to put on their website to document that they have won these badges, and expand on last year's brigade awards. This team is led by Noel and supported by Christopher, both of which are on the call as well. So just like we just talked about here, where we did something really cool and we forgot to tell anybody we did something really cool, we have a problem with getting louder and making sure that we tell people we did cool stuff. So I'm gonna encourage everybody to, if you don't have a Medium account, think about signing up for one and think about writing a blog for CFA. It's not really for CFA, but it will go on the CFA's Medium channel, and it will tell more civic tech wins across our network, and also dispel this idea that civic tech is dead. But what it does is you show up as the author, and then it publishes to CFA. And the more of those we do, the louder we're going to get. To that end, Christopher will be writing a more in-depth blog post about civic tech wins across the network each month. So you might hear him reaching out to ask you questions about wins and things like that. So he has some fodder to write about, or you can just send him fodder. And as I talked about earlier, because we haven't talked yet, building the brigade brand and voice. A big part of that is differentiating ourselves from CFA. To build a brigade brand that's separate from Code for America. This helps avoid confusion about what our members do versus internal Code for America work. This also makes it easier for us to get funding, tell our stories, things like that. This will also include updates to the Code for America Brigade website that will help differentiate us. So in order to do all of that, your 9 tired and overworked NAC members can't do this alone. So we need everybody to kind of pitch in. And help us make these things that we've all talked about, that we all know we want, actually a reality. So one way you're going to do that is the brigade survey. This will help us respect your time if you fill it out prior to your NAC conversation, for which I think we'll be reaching out in the next week to start setting those up. And if you go to this link, you can fill out the survey before then. Then we have some information that we don't have to go over it again. You only need one survey per brigade. Total typo. That's awesome. And yeah, so just one per each brigade, and then we will just elect one person to do it. Okay, do you guys have questions? I'm going to stop sharing my screen so we can chat, because this feels weird.
So I'm going to unmute everyone. That way people can talk.
Wired through online advertising and improving our organic search status.
I didn't hear that.
I'm not sure it was relevant. It someone who is talking on the phone should mute themselves.
Gotcha.
The one you have, the county portal thing for Google, was probably in it.
Yeah. Hi, this is Gary in Savannah.
Hey, Gary.
We are just starting our brigade. Carl Lewis is heading it. But I like the last part about branding. And Carl has been trying to not use the word data, not use the word tech, and just trying to use Open Savannah. And I guess, is that okay?
Absolutely. In all honesty, and I think I told this to him, if I had had the choice on Code for Charlotte, I would have named it Open Charlotte in a heartbeat.
Okay. Great. Okay. So obviously, you know, Carl, so that's good.
Yeah. I think we exchanged messages in, or everybody else had given him the exact same answer prior to me answering him. Something yeah. like that. It was a message in Slack.
Yeah.
I say do it. Get started.
Right. No, he's already done opensavannah.org.
Oh. Perfect. Any other thoughts?
You can also call it beta. In New York City, we call beta NYC just because we think we're in a perpetual state of improvement.
Is there more information on the body cam project? Is that crime related, body cam, police?
Yeah, so the Open Austin one, they've got a great website. Let me find it for you.
Yeah, Gary, are you in the Slack yet?
I am on Slack, yes.
Great. Yeah, that's one of the best places to ask for that if you guys are ever curious. A lot of people will chime in, even if it's not the right person, they usually know who is the right person to talk to.
Savannah has a crime issue, so.
Here it is.
So, brigade members, we'd love feedback on the rally cry, the idea of the bats, and the what sounds good, what sounds like it needs some more work.
Are there any action areas that somebody missed, like something you were excited that, or is there nothing that appeals to you, like what's something missing?
This could be added in, but I'd love to see, this is actually on second thought something that might need to be done at the local level, but how you engage, how each brigade engages with their local governments, whether they be city governments or county governments, and just providing the value pitch to any number of governmental agencies about why engaging with your brigade is a good idea.
Hunt, do you see that as like something that would be sort of a training workshop you could go to, or like a blog post read, or what do you see that looking like?
Probably blog post would be great, like why you local government official should go to a brigade meetup would be a good blog post to send around to my particular network.
And for you, those of you who don't know, Hunter works for the city of Los so.
He's been added.
I'd love him to forward that to his colleagues.
Michelle Funk had done a great, she moderated a panel that I sat on at Summit that was that exact thing. It was geared towards government staff, why you want to participate in your brigades. So, I think we have some fodder for it. We just haven't written it down.
You know, it sounds like that'd be a good candidate for the knowledge base too, so that we can get a good starting point and then we can add to it as we go.
Exactly.
Yeah, hi, this is Terry from DC.
Hey, Terry.
Hey, I had a question about, was there a specific date you were shooting for when you wanted to have all the brigade action teams like staffed and working and doing things?
Not to have all of them rolled out. So I sent out a link to a survey that allows you to start signing up for them.
Got it. So there's no real like closing on the sign up date? Like you're able to sign up until mid-February, or it's just kind of like rolling as we get names in and put them on the brigade action teams that need them if they're interested in that brigade action team? Something like that?
We haven't talked to anyone. I would assume it's kind of like a project team. But Charlotte, we're always onboarding new people on project teams. So I would assume they're kind of the same. Hey Vicky, do you have an opinion on the close day for the bat teams?
I think less about a close date than maybe a target size at first. Like, I can't imagine trying to coordinate starting with the trust like more than like 7 people, but we're going to start moving even if it's only 2 of us in the beginning. But I think once we get to a certain size, it'd be unwieldy and we'd have to reconsider, should we split it into smaller teams with more specific focus? But I mean, I want to have our first meeting next month, so just, you know, moving forward.
I just posted a link.
That makes sense.
Yes, we definitely want to emphasize that the brigade action teams are not limited to just captains, but to any member of the brigade. So if you have someone who's really interested in events, but not so much in like being a captain or a core team member, they can participate in the BAT.
So this link that I just sent out about signing, showing up interest in the teams, you can send that wide. Send that to, you know, to your whole brigade if you want.
Yeah, thank you for
really,
sharing.
All that was to sign up for interest at that point, and then we can reach out to you. Hey, Neil.
Yeah, this is Terry again. If we're curious on how many folks have been filling out the form from our hack nights, I mean, we can of course like shoulder surf while they're filling it out because it's a pretty short form. But just to get a number on how effective our sending the link around is, who like should we just ask it in the CFA Slack, or is there someone we should ping specifically just to keep the noise to a specific person. You know what I mean?
I think the form is shared with any NAC member.
Okay, sounds good.
I'm actually checking that now. Christopher, have you got any questions, Nina?
You're on mute, Christopher.
Sorry. John is asking, sorry if this is old hat, given a lot of network so far, but I see challenge of a single brigade brand and national profile versus local autonomy variation. What is the vision sort of like Boy Scouts recognizable widely, but understood that the real identity is very much local?
I'd say right now a lot of what we went through as NAC was that's all the kind of stuff that's those decisions around sort of branding and identity are going to come out of the first couple of months of work, but all secondary because we're going to focus on collaborating together more, supporting each other. And then from that, you know, that experience, it's going to be a challenge because those are two things that are balancing there. And depending on what community you're in, that might take a different form or need to take a different form. So it's, right now, we don't have an established goal, I'd say, for wanting to have one or the other of those. It's totally up in the air because our focus right now is on getting some work done.
Do we have other questions? You can either unmute yourself and ask on the blue jeans, or you can put a message in the chat. One question is, what makes a financial design sustainable? My guess is this is over a two-year effort looking at many local examples of seeing if brigades can learn from each other and to get what counts for them as sustainable. I can answer that a little bit. Sustainable in terms of the brigade program, there's kind of two things we need to work out is how do we help brigades themselves support themselves locally in terms of being able to have enough funds to achieve the things that they want to achieve? And then how do we support the work that it takes to maintain the network? That means my salary. That means this, the money that we pay for Meetup Pro, the money to maintain and moderate Slack, and the different infrastructure resources that we may create as part of sort of the overall network infrastructure.
Okay, here's a different question. If you could get one resource, if you wanted to level up your brigade right now, like what's that hurdle? What's that next resource, tool, thing you need, wherever you are? Is it money? Is it people? Is it time? What's holding people back? Or vice versa, what could, you know, help augment the good work you're already doing if you don't feel held back?
Thank you.
Not everyone all at once.
We're getting some answers. So Michael from Louisville says time. Margo says time. Some talk about Azure and server, server provisioning and those kinds of resources. But yeah, I'll speak as just a captain. I would say time is probably is my biggest thing too.
Tell me more on time. Is that why is time a problem? Because you have a day job and you're splitting things, or you guys can't hire people at other levels to coordinate, or how could you get more time?
And then one of the other questions is, what is the time commitment for the Brigade Action Teams?
That is one we didn't talk about. Yeah, go ahead.
I would assume that would vary depending on how many tasks inside that, action team you're willing to take on or you're interested in taking on. Just like when each of our individual brigade has volunteers, you can't really dictate the time that they give. You gladly take whatever they're willing to give, right? It's kind of the same thing. Vicky, do you want to add to that?
Yeah, I think we started with the minimum commitment will be a once monthly video call with the rest of the team. And then tasks and whatever else your individual team has, but the minimum would be a one hour a month like video call.
I think the beauty of having the bats is that there are going to be different time commitments for each one. So some of them could be a shorter time, some of them could be a medium time, but I think we recognize that that's valuable because it's not a full commitment, right? It's not like you're saying, hey, I'm going to be on this thing for 2 years. Hopefully we're going to be able to, as we develop these out, say, hey, this looks like it's a 6 month commitment, or it looks like it's, we can be transparent about what we think that's going to be up front. And we're going to learn as we go with these four or five pilots that we've got in the queue.
And all the actions of the Brigade Action Teams will have staff support, mostly through me. So things that need to be done like right away, I'll be there to do right away. But ideally, many hands will make light work.
So Patrick, I would agree with your statement about too many cooks in the kitchen. That's why we decided to make the bats with one lead NAC member and then support members, right? So that way there's one person who's kind of responsible for juggling the plates and making those decisions and things like that. Hey, I only briefly saw something in there. How are you? You've been doing bylaws and structures. Both Charlotte and Miami have already created bylaws. If, those are the kinds of things that we need to be sharing. I can send you our bylaws. They've been all approved by the attorney and our 501c3s and got the IRS waiting. And Miami's already got theirs back.
I also think that bylaws and structure are great candidates for the knowledge sharing base.
Absolutely.
The bat that you will be leading, Jill.
Hey, it took us a long time to create our bylaws and go through the process of seating a board. And so sharing that information to make that easier for somebody else is kind of the point.
Patrick asks, has any brigade worked closely with other grassroots good government organizations like the League of Women Voters?
hasn't Philly done a lot of more community-based work? They're still around.
So in New York City, we're members of this thing called the Transparency Working Group, which is a coalition of good government groups dating back to the League of Women Voters, to Common Cause, Citizens Union, NYPIRG, NYCLU. And we stand in solidarity, or really sit in solidarity around a table. And we bring up different issues. It's how we helped get the city's open data law passed.
And Charlotte, we're members of two separate, I like to call them cabals, because I've always wanted to be a member of a cabal, but one of them is a group of nonprofits that we do community advocacy. Another one is tech, related to tech more. And, you know, so.
Yeah, hey, Chris here from Philly. I didn't reach my mute button quick enough. But yeah, we do work with a lot of groups, community groups here in Philly, but one great one we work a lot with is called Committee of 70, and they're a nonprofit kind of election watchdog organization. Post a link to them. They're pretty cool. They actually took over hosting one of our hackathon projects.
Cool. EFF just reached out to Hack for LA, so we're going to start talking to them. They're looking to have us become one of their member I'm not quite sure what the program's called again, but it's a sort of like loose membership orgs, which means they would distribute information about our events to their paying members.
Did you say EFF, Nikki?
Yes.
That's the electronic
Freedom Frontier.
Freedom Foundation. Frontier, yeah.
I know them well.
Yeah, actually, concerning that partnering with community organizations, we have one project, DC Abortion Fund. We built a case manager tool for them that they've deployed and they're using. And the DC Abortion Fund is a smaller coalition under like a national abortion fund thing. And apparently their Baltimore group is pretty strong on the community on the abortion fund side. So we were reaching out to Code for Baltimore, seeing about if they could just deploy this case manager, because apparently they're modeling a lot of what they do off DC's thing anyways. That's an example of like another kind of loosely distributed national organization with local influence, like taking advantage of like a Brigade stuff.
Other questions or thought, or how is everybody feeling about the plans and the initiatives? I know it's a lot of stuff to sort of bring out at once.
This is Neil. I just wanted to encourage you all to step up and believe that we will co-create with you, because we really want to move some of these projects forward for the better of all of us.
Any other thoughts, guys? Jen, you've been really quiet.
So in regards to Open Data Day, Open Data Day is March 4th. What we'd like to do is have the Brigade Action Team that's in charge of Days of Action formed rather quickly, so we can talk about Open Data Day. It is a kind of a tight time frame, but it's a good test to see how we would go about having sort of a National Day of Action, so that when we get to National Day of Civic Hacking or the Brigade Summit later on, we're gonna get more of the kinks out. So if you're interested in helping with sort of helping to organize our national response to Open Data Day, definitely sign up to be part of that action team, because that one's going to get going very, very quickly. You'll probably start seeing messages about that next week.
All things should be punctuated with picking up a cat.
Yes, this is the Kingsley. This one's the troublemaker.
So if you think you guys have questions later that you were apparently too shy to ask or whatever, you can hit us up. Hey, do we have Christopher, can you make a NAC channel on Slack that's open?
Yes, I can. And I will do so immediately.
You guys can hit up a NAC community channel or whatever, and then just ask questions, and then we'll all just kind of we can crowdsource those answers for you.
No, let's. There's group tags, Joe.
Okay, that works.
Make a NAC group tag where it'll ping all nine of us at the same time, whatever channel it's already in.
Cool. Like it.
Are most people aware of how to use that functionality, and should that be documented somewhere so that people who join later on know how to do that?
We can document it. Do you want to explain it now? Did you just volunteer?
I actually am not familiar with the functionality, so that's why I was asking.
Okay, I guess Nikki can.
Yeah, do you know the at channel or at here? You can use them as an alias.
Okay.
So at NAC would only ping us nine instead of having to do the at symbol for all nine of us.
Yeah, okay.
In a separate channel. I'm in a lot of channels. It's very hard to keep track of things.
I think that's a great idea. Hey, Christopher, can you make that happen?
I'm working on it.
Yay!
It can be part of the Slack bot onboarding to the CFA Slack.
Good idea.
I can write up a quick message and send that out to like the Brigade channel and those ones. Vicky does have nice hair.
Thanks, guys.
Do you guys have any other thoughts? Or do you all feel the need to talk to us offline? Silence.
Jill, are we going to share the slides? I know we've got the Medium post that went out last week. It was kind of a summary or a preview to this.
Yeah. That is.
So we'll send a link to the slide deck in the next Brigade leadership email. And then we'll probably do a follow-up blog post, which will also have the slides.
Do you just want them now? Can I just share them now?
Yeah.
As well?
Yes. And then we're recording this workshop. So we'll upload that to YouTube, and then the YouTube will also have a link to the slides.
Okay, I'm great. Beach, you can't wait. There are the slides right now. That's a really good question. When is the next one of these meetings? I don't know, like a month? 2 months? Mm. I feel like that's up for debate. Anybody have thoughts?
Yes, my thought is that as we're building teams, we should be more present, more often. And I guess it depends on maybe on the response to the communications that we're all going to be sharing out and the work that Christopher's going to be doing. I think it'd be nice to check in a month from now.
Okay.
I mean, I know some of us are going to be talking between them.
Yeah, I mean, I guess my question is back to the community. So how often do you want to hear from us, and what are the channels which makes the most sense? Is it big meetings like this that we do once a month? Is it, you know, more frequent stuff by email? It's both, it's all. So like, I'm definitely interested in hearing, you know, back from you guys. What, how much do you want to hear from us, and about what?
We're listening.
I know Savannah's meeting on February 21st. And we're in touch with Slack, so in the meantime, that should do.
This is Hima from Code for Princeton. I think a mandatory kind of meeting once in 2 months at least happens and everybody shows up is a good idea. Something or many forms of communication open would be a good idea, one or the other.
So responding to Ernie, a weekly email would be great so we can update our members with inspiration from other brigades. Right now, I send a weekly leadership email. If you're not getting that, let me know, and I'll make sure you're added to the list. The weekly email is more of a summary, so it's all bullet points. I'm going to start doing a this month in Civic Tech that goes a little bit more in-depth. If you have blogged about a brigade win and want to have it sent out to the wider network, let me know, because we have a Code for America Medium channel. If you're on Medium and post your blog on Medium, we can have you join our Medium channel and publish your blog on our publication so we can share your stories.
And Christopher, did we have a discussion around maybe adding a section to your weekly leadership update for like message from the NAC? I think we had talked about adding that component to it.
Yes.
Anyone else? It feels like pulling teeth you guys to talk. Man, if you put you all in the same room, nobody shuts up.
Man, your presentation was so spot on, man. It's just that, and there's so much to absorb.
Right. It's a lot of information thrown at you quick, so it makes sense, but that's why we want to make sure that there's ways to hit us up on Slack and stuff afterwards. If you think of something 10 minutes after you hang up on this call, just hit us on there.
Yeah, and then if if you're not on that weekly brigade leadership email and you want to be, or you're not in the CFA Slack, make sure you get your email to Christopher Whitaker and indicate which one you're not in or both, so we can get you all, as we're figured out, you know, better tracking of onboarding, because right now we don't really know who is or isn't on those emails or the Slack versus whose leadership.
And as appropriate, although Christopher, I don't know if you consider yourself a community manager, today is Community Manager Appreciation Day. So thank you, Christopher, for all you do to help us get through all this stuff.
Yay. Thank you, guys.
We should probably sign off on that note.
Well, yeah. Happy Monday.
Are you guys all good?
Thank you, everyone, for joining.
Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, everyone. Hey.